Airport, right after the San Francisco. We're starting our trip. Good morning, buddy.
San Francisco was the green empire.
Yes, here we go.
Here we go.
Here we are at Fisherman's Wharf. We're walking around and we're headed out to lunch to an old favorite place of Bertie's called Scoma's Restaurant. See you there. At the restaurant at Fisherman's Wharf, overlooking the water. We are at Fisherman's Wharf. And we just had a scrumptiousness lunch. Dungeness crab, baby shrimp, french fries. Oh, what a good lunch. It was 100, Debbie. Excellent. This is more of the harbor at Fisherman's Wharf. And we're off to Ghirardelli Square. A minute ago, I said we're off to Ghirardelli Square. Well, that's it. Here we are in Ghirardelli Square. And here's one of the famous San Francisco cable cars. And this is the famous street where the cable cars ride up. Well, folks, Ghirardelli Square. We had to walk up a huge hill to get here. But we're in chocolate paradise. Paradise. And here we are inside the Ghirardelli Chocolate place where you get the ice cream. All right, and number 497. Well, here we are in chocolate heaven.
This is wonderful and delicious.
Oh, yeah. Sitting on the hill outside of Ghirardelli Square and in the distance in the San Francisco Bay is Alcatraz. We haven't been able to tour that, but you can see it very clearly from where I'm standing. Here we are in the hotel room, and we're overlooking the city of San Francisco at night. We are on the 18th floor. This is the view from our room. Isn't it pretty? Here's a picture of our bus. We're at the Sterling Vineyard, and we're on our way to see wine being made. Sterling Winery, and we're on our way up to the top of the mountain. Here we are. Yes, we're at a tram stop at the top of the Sterling Wineries, overlooking the winery. It's a beautiful day.
It wasn't a very big thing like it is today here in the valley. He bought his first vineyard, which was just bordering Calistoga, a little bit north of here, and the locals started calling it Sterling's Vineyard. And so when he bought this property, he decided, which was in about 1950, and that's the current owner.
We're putting the gates into the order
to avoid any contamination. So they're going through and checking. You can see as they're going down the conveyor belt, the guys are going to make sure there's no cheese or any big particles going in.
These are the red things.
Must off the side. And oh my gosh, it would just get so almost intoxicating. When the fumes coming up, it's just like, okay, I've had enough.
We're on the top roof of the winery. And this is the countryside of the winery.
No, I mean, picnicking?
No, they'll keep going.
This is the view from the top of the winery roof. Isn't this beautiful?
Well, they're purple, but they're red.
That's where we're standing.
Just like it depends on the varietal of the table grape, on how dark this is our light view. Is. Yeah. But you can see out here too, you can see a lot of
think
our,
you know this person.
Vineyards and the different.
We're in a tasting room waiting for our free sample. And this is the view out of one of the windows. Look how pretty it is today. Napa Valley, wine country.
Trunks are original pieces, and they are very beautiful. Yeah, unfortunately, in this, you know, multiple sales of the winery, the information on them has been lost, and also
there you are.
Also, a lot of the keys for things. So some of these trunks, like this one here, has not been opened in a long time, to the best of my knowledge. Lock that up. But some of the things are real fun.
In Sacramento this evening at the Hyatt Regency, and I'm in a hotel room, and this is a picture of the Capitol at Sacramento lit up. Good morning, we're at the Hyatt Regency Sacramento, and we're leaving to go to the Gold Country.
And Yosemite.
And Yosemite. And here are real California palm trees. And our hotel has these cute, real cute topiaries running along the street side. Aren't they cute? Well, we're at the town of Columbia. Where the gold mines were. This is the original courthouse.
Year-round, they needed to have water come in. What they did was they formed a water company. The nearest water source is the Stanislaus River. It is only 5 miles away, but in order to build flumes and to bring it again, here's another fee on a daily basis. $2 a day again, well, out of $10, that's a sizable amount. The water company enjoyed this thoroughly. They made money very quickly, hand over fist, as a matter of fact. To the degree that people were joking, and they would say, the water company does a better job of it. They saw they were making money, they upped it $3, $4, they ended up $6 a day for the privilege of mining in their water. That was for a 10-foot section of stream. So pretty expensive. The reason we're poised right here, would you be surprised if I told you the president of the water company becomes the president of the bank?
Talbotroy. So the blossoms look like long string beans, native to this area. These are elm trees that were planted in 1850. This is the opposite end of town. City hotels where we're having lunch. Hi, we're in Yosemite. This is our room at the Ahwahnee Hotel. We're in room 217.
It's beautiful, it's lovely.
It is. See, we have these two nice beds and a cute little bathroom, but no vanity.
The light on?
However, look what they have for us in here. Our own bathrobes. Yes. A cute little bathroom. The old-fashioned sink. And we're going to go take a look right out the window, the view out of our hotel window. And look at Mother Nature's majesty. This is our view of the majesty of Yosemite. Tomorrow we're going on the grand tour. That's going to take us all over the park. We're going to be going from 8:45 till 5, but we're going to see it all. See you soon. Right below us is a nice little patio to sit outside. We're having dinner at 7 o'clock.
Here we are at El Capitan. Right here to the left of that tall pine. But you can see these up here real easy. You can see the white haul bag, which can carry 200 pounds of food, water, and equipment. Because if you're going to climb for 3 or 4 days, you're going to have to bring some...
This is the face of El Capitan. This is sheer rock.
And they sleep on
all the way to the top.
It's a cot that they can unfold and be quite comfortable. This is what it looks like.
There's climbers right there.
This is on this rock. And you can see all the equipment he brought. Put the beach on it, the wedges in the track.
There's climbers right there.
There are dozens of climbing crowds.
These are climbers right here. And we have these giant tall pine trees.
However long it takes them to move up a pitch. There is another group right here that are real easy to see. You can see the leader above the haul bag, and he or she will be in place in the protection.
Those heights. The reason I know them pretty well is I hiked to the top of all of them.
Redwood Forest. And this is a close-up of a Mariposa redwood. They grow to be 300 feet tall, and then they just get wider and wider and wider and wider till they fall over. Beautiful red color. Beautiful red color. We're on the grand tour today. This is fun. This is the biggest redwood.
It has a rather precarious lean to it, more than the Leaning Tower of Pisa, but it's been that way for a couple thousand years or more leaning, and it's adapted to it. A butterfly could be enough to tip it over when it's ready to go, but it's more likely going to be a heavy snow and a gust of wind or an earthquake. And it's ready to go any second now, and most of them don't get that big before they topple, but this one's a survivor. There, since the golden age of Greece and the pyramids were new, this one was just a young tree. If you would like to compare that to the biggest tree in the world, you can walk down.
We're at the base of that giant redwood.
Grizzly.
And this is good grizzly. And look how tall the tree is. Way, 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 way up to the sky. These have very shallow roots, so they've started fencing them off so that you don't walk on the roots.
Talk, say something.
One, two, or one? Ah, hello. Okay.
Thank you. Let's take a group shot.
Yeah. I just took one shot.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Do we have to be online?
With the Volkswagen going through it, the postcard down at the museum. Because the mountain redwood shattered easily, it was brittle and splintered. Didn't make as good of building material, but they still cut down the biggest one. Any heartwood, which is dead wood anyway, yet that tree is still perfectly alive. That really testifies to how these trees can handle fire.
All right, Glacier Point. This is the highest part of the park. Half Dome.
I love it. That was why they demolished it for. You don't even see the other one.
Thank you. Here's one of the two waterfalls that are flowing today. Here's the second waterfall.
Are you sure? What do you
think you're supposed to be? The Ahwahnee Hotel we were staying from the top of Glacier Point. This is what we were viewing. These are all the points of interest. And Glacier Point. This is the Irani dining room. And there's Birdie. And a new friend that we've met. Dolores. And this is Saturday night, and this is where we're having dinner. Isn't it lovely? The beautiful chandeliers. Dinner table Saturday night. This is Birdie, our new friend Dolores, Maria Napolitano, Joe Schrader, and Linda. These are our new friends that we're having dinner with tonight. The San Luis Reservoir, it's a part of a hydro generating plant in the San Joaquin Valley. This is a reservoir that eventually finds its way down to Los Angeles. Today is Sunday afternoon, and it's a beautiful and hot California day. And it's really, it's 2 o'clock in the afternoon. We're going over these mountains, they're called the Diablo Mountains, and walk our way into Monterey, California. Monterey Sea Aquarium, and we're at the jellyfish exhibit. Look at this jellyfish, isn't that neat? A long tentacle called the purple striped jelly. These are called sea nerds. Sea nerds. S-E-A-N-E-T-T-L-E. Look at the long tentacle. Sea nerds. Jellyfish. Look at this. Just like a pulsating anchor. Rod cone jellyfish. Look how faint that is. You can hardly see it. And right up on the glass. Look at these little teeny babies.
Look at
that
little teeny babies.
Nice. Crystal jellyfish. Look, girls, a giant turtle. Fish. Fish in the Outer Bay. Big fish yelling on the own, and Hannah. He's a big guy. Pacific sardines. Girls, this is your first look at the Pacific Ocean. See the sailboats in the water? We saw sea otters today. Rocks. This is California Cat. It's a seaweed in the water. See kayakers. Nice boats. And the city of Monterey in the distance. Oops. Sorry about that, a bug got me. This is a general panorama of Monterey in the Pacific Ocean. You can hear it. Into the roar of the Pacific Ocean. It's crashing on the rocks. And you can see right here. Hi, alien Han and Lauren. Look, there's a seagull at the aquarium. And he says, hi, alien Han and Lauren. Hear the ocean crashing? Big, nice big waves. Oh, isn't that nice? I wonder if we'll see any sea otters. We saw some sea otters inside being fed by a trainer. This is the Pacific Ocean, girls. Someday Gammy's going to bring you to see it. It's beautiful.
In the middle of the outer basin, if you haven't leaned here to go, with the plexiglass there and the acrylic there, it's actually almost, what, 11 and a half feet?
Okay. It's a diver.
And one of the animals that really likes to eat jellies is the gorgeous, beautiful sea turtle.
Absolutely.
And while this may look like a jelly, it doesn't digest like a jelly.
So we encourage you, if you see these sort of things in the beach or in the ocean,
doesn't have a lid on it.
Here's a starfish.
Because, you know, the kelp forest is really, it's beautiful. It provides tremendous habitat for an awful lot of fish. But it's really important.
Look at that big starfish.
Important.
Nice. Let's give me that.
Really care of,
This is what they're talking about today. Kelp. It's a viney seaweed that the sun and his feet are there.
And then, you know, grow up to the surface,
that
which
grow,
Warren, what do you say, almost up to 2 feet a day?
It can. Even here in our exhibit, it's through the vibrations of our skulls that actually stimulates our inner ear. So you're all using your heads to listen to this, not just your ears.
And
are you blue from the cold, or...
Fish girls. It's called a sheephead fish.
Yeah, we were talking earlier that a lot of the plants have come in here, and they don't care, rock or window, makes the same no difference to them.
Goodness.
So it wasn't the standard specifically for this exhibit. So it looks kind of like the things you see in the oil fields, those that go up and down, and it simulates the water movement, the wave, the gentle wave action that the kelp needs. Too strong would wash the plants away, not strong enough, they'd starve to death. It has to be just...
We're at the octopus gallery. Here's one of the little creatures. This on the side. He's a big guy. Yeah. And look at these beautiful creatures.
Yeah.
Giant octopus. Giant octopus, guys.
I'd love to have one of those.
He climbs out of the tank.
Here's his eye.
So what they did is they put ostrich around the tank, and they can't hold on to it.
Tentacles.
And that's the only thing that keeps it, because those roamings are different tanks.
These are called the chambered cuttlefish.
Ooh, aren't
He's funny looking.
It looks like a hippopotamus, but it's a fish. Chambered nautilus.
What's in here?
Whoops.
Do you see something in
there? Chambered nautilus. We're on a 17-mile drive down the coastal highway, and this is a rock loaded with seals. Can you see them, girls? They're making noisy. Look at these guys. This is the Pacific Ocean. Can you hear the waves? Look at the waves. Look at this beautiful scenery. You can see the waves. Smells just like the ocean.
Do you hear the sea line?
Look at the seagull. Look at the ocean. Hi, little seagull. Look, Gilly, Hannah, and Lauren. The ocean. The Pacific Ocean. Look at the sky, girls. Uh-oh. Isn't he big? This is where we are, Bird Rock, listening to the seals. Hey Joe, say hi to my grandchildren.
Hi grandchildren.
There you go, those dolphins.
A bunch of dolphins, and they're jumping up and down.
Yeah. Look at that.
And the sea lion is up on the figure.
Right. Girls, I don't know what this stuff is. It looks, it's some kind of foam. But you can see it all out all over the waves. Look at. Looking out for a cyclone fence along the coastal highway. Let's see, push point. The fence is so high I can't see over the top of it. It's a sea lion or a sea otter.
Yeah. Lots of them.
He's
yeah.
on the top of the rock. Cypress. I am at the Pebble Beach golf course. And we're walking down one of the promenades. Look at all the golf stuff. But look at all the flowers. Say hi, Birdie.
Hi.
Look at this. It cost a fortune to play golf here, Robbie. This is the lodge, Robbie, at the Pebble Beach Golf Resort. When you know where to play golf, where the rich and wealthy come to meet, this is the place. It is gorgeous. Plaza in Carmel, California. And as you can see from the names, only the best. From the middle of the shopping plaza. The hanging baskets are gorgeous. And in the middle of this mall, there's a little cafe where you can sit down and you can even have an open flame. Isn't this nice? The gorgeous hanging baskets. They're everywhere. They're just gorgeous.